talk shows even do Christmas? It doesn't matter.
Have you been talking this whole time?
Hey everybody, we got a great show for you tonight. We got musical guests from Farts of Dioxys, and special guest appearance from Lady Gaga's distant cousin that I found allegedly on Craigslist. And for an extra.
You didn't stop.
What?
You did not stop. Fucking left.
Anyway, folks, we got a great show for you tonight. Like I said, we'll get back to you in a little bit. Don't worry, the opening monologue in a second. Don't worry, folks. We'll be coming at you again. Merry Christmas, everyone. And then bah, 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 bah. This is a Christmas special. Am I right, Chris?
Leave me alone.
I don't understand why I have to do that. So, recently in the news, everyone, there's been this thing going around. It's been Harambe. Ah? Ah? Hey, anyone remember that? Gorilla?
Please.
You remember him? You remember the gorilla?
Please overdose on medication.
Yeah, he's been in the news again. He's been coming up. I guess he published a book or something. You know, it's pretty crazy. Anyway, so like I was saying, Harambe has been in the news recently. He's got a new book coming out, and
that is exactly what you just said.
I was trying to get back on track here because, like I said before, we do actually offer jobs from kids that are either mentally challenged or we're not going to be adopted. So we have actually gotten many PAs from different clinics. A lot of kids are coming from the abortion homes. They're around the age of like 17 or so, and like they're probably not going to get adopted. So we just take them in. We try to give them a job, give them a foot in the industry, and then we also employ a lot of people with special needs. So if there's ever
like
something
fucking
that
you,
if there's ever something that you might hear that you might be like, oh, what was that? It's probably one of them. They don't exactly know how everything works. We're trying to, you know, teach them the ropes and all that. So, you know, forgive us for that. But at the same time, we're doing a good thing. It's all in the name of giving these kids
hey,
a home and a family. So, you know, I hope that you guys can understand that, because we do have a lot of special needs folks in here and a lot of people kind of down on their luck, yeah, employed, but, you know, they're doing their best, just like everyone should be trying. All right, so back to what I was saying. Harambe in the news, you know, his book, apparently it's about the incident he was in a few years back, if you remember that, where he actually got shot and killed. He died. Allegedly, and it was all because of a baby falling into his alleged home, which was his. He did own, and he was only trying to protect it by dragging it around. But the owners of the zoo thought that the best course of action was to kill him in his own home. So he's kind of brought a little bit more light on the situation in his book, and you know, it's a pretty good read. I suggest everyone watch it and read it. Watch the visual novel.
You better watch me knock out all your teeth.
And, yeah, so that's just something I wanted to bring up. That's sort of what I've been doing for the past week or so. And in other news, a new emoji was made this week. It was actually a guy pulling his ass apart and shitting everywhere. And I think that's a pretty good one. So that's some news there. That's some pop culture news about the iPhone. I know how everyone loves their iPhones and such, so there's a little bit of that. Also, in the news this week, Hurricane Katrina coming back again? Question mark. We don't know. I sure do hope that this time my basement doesn't get flooded with my dog in there. That would be bad. I would not like that. So, yeah, that's something. Another interesting thing about Hurricane Sandy actually been found to be related to Sandy Hook. Relationships have been found between the two, linking the events even. So potentially some new things coming out of that side of the crazy world we live in. We got a great show for you tonight, folks. A lot of people coming on. It's going to be fantastic. I hope you all are in the holiday spirits. We got the choir from the adoption center coming in tonight, actually. They don't know how to sing, but they're trying to get adopted, so you can actually call in, and if you see one you want, you can pick them out and adopt them on the spot. Our phone lines are open. Hey, Chris, I need you to do me a favor.
What's up?
I need you to come on the show. I need you to come on the show. We got two guests. One of them is being real iffy right now with me. I need you to come on the show. And I need you to talk about something that you've been doing. Could you do this for me? Hey everyone, welcome back to the show, Lay Faggot. We got Chris on tonight. He's gonna tell us a little bit about what he's been up to. Chris, why don't you tell all the fine folks at home what you've been up to? Oh yeah, that, you know. Yeah, I do remember that. Yes, it's okay, so. All right, Chris, everyone, that was a great interview. I asked one question and he kind of took it away, but you know, that's how it works here. Shut the fuck up. Shut your fucking mouth. All right, everyone, we got our next guest tonight. Lady Gaga's distant cousin. She actually found me off an Instagram ad that I put out for the show. She messaged me and said that she actually has famous relatives, so figured we might as well have her on. Maybe she could give us a little bit of insight into what it's like to be a celebrity's relative, you know. And who knows? Maybe we could even get her to try and call Miss Gaga. So. Who knows? All right, hello, Miss Gaga's distant relative. How's everything been? I heard you took the bus here and you had a little bit of trouble on the way. A dog actually, a dog came in and bit you on the leg because it smelt the bacon you had wrapped around there. Yeah, that's tough. Not too sure why you have bacon wrapped around your leg, but, you know, to each their own, I guess. So, you know, but how have you been? And, is there any, you know, I'm just going to cut to the chase here. Is there any way we're going to be able to get Ms. Gaga on the show? Would you be able to call her, potentially? No? Oh, you lied about everything just to try and get publicity for you stupid fucking dumb bitch hair salon. Okay, well, get off my show.
What the hell are you doing?
Chris, how's it going? How's the show, Chris? Hey, ladies and gentlemen, it's the Chris Cam. Everyone, look at this Chris Cam. Everyone, look at Chris. He set up hidden cameras in his toilet. Look at his balls.
What?
Look at his balls. Great show for you tonight, folks. We got a great show for you tonight. We actually got Dioxys Fart coming in later on tonight to give us a little bit of the rundown on what's happening in the world of music. Their lead drummer actually had a little falling out with the band One Direction. Now defunct band One Direction. He actually has been in contact with several members trying to get credit card information from them. It has not been working. He's been posing as an agent and a woman to try and get them to give him information he wants, but they're not budging, people. They're not budging. So let's get those phone lines going, you know what I'm saying, people? Let's try and get this guy his money.
South Yorkshire.
So, Chris, how you doing?
I'm listening to this fucking retard ramble.
How's the show been tonight, Chris? Yeah, I bet you wish you had a show that premieres on cable.
Dude, you're not even good enough for fucking cable.
I want cable. Channel 3.
You can fucking hang yourself with it.
I'm on Channel 3. I air at 5 a.m.
What's up, Becca Tolman?
I air at 5 a.m.
I cannot think of that fucking sandwich.
God, dude, I'm trying to think of it right now.
Dude, I'm desperately trying to think about it.
I'm on a Google Maps. My friend, who I thought we both know, so my friend who I'm going out to dinner with, he was like, where do you want to go? I said, so Hungies. And I forgot that I did not actually give him an answer.
So hungies.
Great show for you tonight, folks. We actually have a new guest showing up.
Dude,
Jack.
He's been doing this for like an hour. He's just talking to himself.
Great show for you tonight, folks. We actually got Jack, who I've met, and we know things about each other. He's a person I know, and he's on the show tonight.
Is it good?
He's on the show tonight.
It probably was be good, right? Wait, what did you? Do you remember what you ordered?
A chicken sandwich.
He's talking with chicken. The retarded PA.
And, like, a smoothie.
It was most definitely be good, I'm pretty sure. It has to be good. I'm pretty sure it's be good. Oh, yeah, because I'm remembering it now, because I got that, like, chicken burger with the bacon and the avocado.
Yeah.
So, yeah, it was definitely be good. Oh.
Everyone, Chris the retarded PA.
Why am I retarded now?
You were adopted, but then you made fun of the show, so now you're retarded.
I have been making fun of the show since.
And Chris the retarded PA, everyone, thank you for coming on, Chris. Thank you.
You made me fart.
Oh, hey, guys, you know what I just figured out?
An extra retard?
Yes, but...
Aww!
Yes. What did you just figure out?
that if you put finger. if you go into the game settings and put bottomless clip on, the target designator, the thing that you can put a little marker on the map and then just launch a fucking just barrage of missiles, you can have infinite shots with that. It works with the gun.
Bro. I work with a gun.
I work.
You're poor.
Not as poor as the retired PA Chris. Everyone, retired PA Chris. Welcome to the show, Chris. Yeah.
Glad to be here.
Out in dirt, New York.
Dirt.
That's where the show's hosted.
It's the best offer we could get. Landlord is actually a goblin, real life goblin, everyone, and I have to pay 200% up from what the actual place is worth. So, trying to turn a profit here.
You got extorted, faggot.
Gotta turn a profit on the show, people. So let's get going here, everyone.
We got
a great show for you tonight. We got Axe Like Fart from Planet Z coming here with a new album. We got Danny Copperletter. He's a guy I know. He fixes my toilet every time it breaks, which is often because I live in a very bad place. We also have people like Jack, who I just know. That's it. That's all that it is. And then we also have a special guest star appearance from my mom, everyone. My mom. She is not a fan of the show. She actually thinks that I'm a disgrace to the family, but I asked her to be on to try and make some money back.
I'll go make some nice coffee. I'll be right back.
This is, of course, brought to you by the letter Z. And that is an orphanage where we get a lot of the kids who work on the show. We're trying to give them a second chance at life because most of these kids are 17 and probably not going to get adopted. So they're just going to be thrust out on the street and not have any idea what to do. So I take them in, and you can buy them if you want. You can adopt them. Our lines are open always. If you would like to buy them, just let me know, and you know. We'll work it out. Well, I have my grandmother working the paperwork, so.